It's time, boys.
I am Mighty Keith.
Okay, so if you guys keep up with me on Twitter, you're probably like, Keith, we know you're interested in Final Smashes. This is just a video preaching about why you think they should be legal. Incorrect. Not at all, in fact. Now, it is true that I am intrigued in the idea of a world where we have special moves like Final Smashes that can be implemented into the game, only if they are balanced. This video is more of a discussion. This isn't about, hey, I think it should be legal, here's the reason why. This is more of, well, like I said, should they be legal? A discussion. What you guys think, what I think, and you know, moving on. So about 2 days ago, there was a tweet by Source Gaming that kind of spread like wildfire through the Smash Twitterverse. And so everyone, I'm just talking everyone, was talking about this, they were debating on it. Well, it wasn't really too much of debating because it's kind of plain in letters what the intentions are for the Final Smashes. But basically the tweet went like this. You can change the Final Smash settings to meter, which changes over time. By default, this option is off. Sakurai does note that this setting is better suited to casual party play over serious competitive play. So, I guess there you have it. that's now we're gonna get into something. That's the translation of what these people are talking about over in, I guess, the latest article of Famitsu for Sakurai. And so what it's saying is that he's saying that this is more for the casual play, not for competitive. Now, with this tweet, of course, all the anti-Final Smash players were just like rejoicing. They got a big W because now we don't even have to have a conversation about changing up the rules or anything. We can just stay with the same old pattern of Smash that we've had for the last 18 years, which is not a bad thing. I mean, Smash is Smash. It's always going to be fun. But there are people who wanted to see if maybe we could kind of switch up some stuff. That's, you know, every fighter usually does that. A lot of traditional fighters implement different things in its next iteration of the game. But with Smash, we've kind of always been that whole 2-3-4 stock. I mean, a 4 stock in Melee, but 3 stock in Brawl. It was 3 stock in Smash 4 for a little bit. Then it migrated to 2 stock. Now people are talking about 3 stocks again for Smash 5. But I'm not going to get into that. We've always been like, you play with stocks and that's it. There are no other mechanics really besides Rage Mode, but I guess, yeah, Rage Mode is like the first mechanic that was kind of introduced by the developers to switch things up, and everyone hated that. So I don't even know if 100% we're even gonna play with that in the next game. Bottom line is, we're still at the same fundamentals. Again, admittedly, I would have been okay. I don't even know if I would have 100% said let's do Final Smashes, but I would have been interested in the idea of talking about Final Smashes if they were balanced. Which it looks like at this time they are not. I have no idea what's going to happen in the final build. It is 4 months away. There are a lot of changes that can be made. Sakurai is, he could change his mind. We have no idea what's going to happen. But as of right now, it does look like it is not looking pretty good for the pro Final Smashers. Now, another part of the translation states that the Final Smash actually builds over time. Okay, meaning you could just exist and you start building meter. So that's a bad thing because it can encourage campingness, because why would I approach you if I know that in 30 seconds I'm gonna have a move that one-shots you? So that could probably be bad. However, when I went to the actual article of where this tweet originated from, or was, you know, taken the information from, in the actual article, it doesn't really say that it charges over time. It doesn't specifically say it charges over time. It just says it charges while you're fighting. So I don't know, people can interpret that as, well, are you gonna get hit? If not, you know, I have no idea what the actual wording is because it's different on both the origin of the article and the tweet. So I it's still up in the air. Now there is a video in the direct that shows Mario getting meter when he's hit by Wii Fit Trainer. I don't see him getting meter anytime before that. If somebody has a frame by frame that they can show me, or maybe some way you can super like a super slow-mo or something, that'd be great. Because it looks like to me, Mario's not getting any meter by just existing. He's either doing something or he's getting hit, and then that's when it dings for his Final Smash to come up, and then he uses it. And of course, in that build, it does look like the Final Smash was a lot weaker than if he had got the Smash Ball. Now, to continue with the article, That I did notice that, of course, you know, he said it's for casual players and things of that nature. I guess what kind of confused me or what seemed conflicting is that in the article, it states that the final smash that we're going to get with the meter is supposed to simulate other traditional fighting games where they do supers or ultra combos. And so for those who don't know, ultra combos in Street Fighter 4 and I think 5, it is kind of like a revenge meter that you build after you get hit, and then you can do this whopping, incredibly large, damaging attack, right? What I don't understand is that's for competitive play though. The ultras and the supers, those are all in competitive play. So why would the final smash for this be not for competitive play? I don't know. That's all. I mean, I'm not gonna read too much into it, but that, you see how that can be kind of conflicting, because it's saying it's supposed to simulate something that's in competitive play for other games. However, for this game, it's not gonna be competitive at all. So that's why I was a little confused. Another thing that kind of got me was that they are specifically toning down the damage and whatnot for the metered version of the final smashes. So I don't understand why they would do that if the end result is that the final smashes are supposed to be for casual play. What is the point of toning it down anyway if it's not supposed to be competitive? It's those things like that that are just a little like, I would love some more clarification. But as it stands, like I said, we can only go off what Source Gaming has said. I've been doing my research about them. They seem pretty credible. So, you know, not going to say anything right now about it, but what I can say is that really no one's going to know what happens until the final build. But as of right now, as it stands, that's all we can go for, is that Sakurai did say in that translation that it is more suited for casual play right now. Now, while this was happening, people did on Twitter state that Smash in its entirety was supposed to be meant for casual play, as said by Sakurai many years ago. All right, so people are thinking that Sakurai's perspective of casual play is possibly something completely different from what we see as casual play or competitive play. You know, because Melee in general, Melee 64, everything, they even though it looks like it's competitive, or it's, you know, it is competitive, Sakurai said he designed it for casual play. So if back in 2000 and when did Melee come out? 4? I completely forget. It's so long ago. Back when Melee came out, if he had made an article saying this game is supposed to be for casual play, how do you think people would have responded? They would have said, okay, well, we're only going to play it as a casual. Let's not start any tournaments about this game or anything like that. Clearly, that didn't happen. Melee has had a very illustrious career. It's been amazing throughout all these years, and it's still going, and it's going to probably continue to go until the end of time, or until they make Melee HD, which will probably be never shots anyways. And I would agree with those people who said that if this was like before Smash 4. I think that now Sakurai has gathered enough data about our scene to kind of be like, yeah, I know what the competitive scene is now. I don't think that these are going to be balanced. So I'm not sure if I'm going to put this in, or I'm not sure if I'm going to design this for the competitive scene. So I would agree with you guys if this was Brawl days, because then I'd say, well, maybe his perspective of casual just isn't on the same line as ours is. But I think right now he does understand more. And so I think if this is true and he's saying like this is not supposed to be for competitive, or, you know, I wouldn't have it for competitive, then that's that, you know, that's how it is. But then again, he did design Bayonetta, and he did design Bayonetta for competitive play. So again, I have many questions. As I was telling people earlier, these designers, they've made over 70 characters to be playable in this next game. We're around 80 characters, and they're probably gonna announce another 5 or 6, okay? So let's just say 80 plus characters are gonna be in Smash Ultimate. They designed all these cinematics for Final Smashes for all 80 characters. That's a lot of time and a lot of resources and a lot of money, which I guess was the resource, to go into these characters just for them to not be shown. That just seems a little weird. And now when I say that is like, you create a game and you want all the contents, all the aspects of your games to be shown, especially something like 80 cinematics for characters. All right, so not just the cinematics either, they have to do the damages and everything like that, knockback, all that jazz, right? So it seems a little weird that they just would not want that to be shown ever, because they know what the competitive scene's like. They know that's where all the eyes are seeing the game. And so I figured if you want your work to be shown the most, it would be you would put it for competitive play, which makes me think that's why they made all the stages legal. Basically, they made a Final Destination and Battlefield form of every stage. They knew they were going to put over 100 stages in here, and they thought, well, what's the point of putting 100 stages in the game if they're only going to play on Battlefield, Final D, and Smashville, right? So that kind of just wastes the other. But they allowed it so that now all the stages can technically be legal. Okay, so I mean, if you want a cool stage, if you want to go to something that's incredibly broken, also they turned off hazards, you know, and they made those stage transitions, even though I don't know if that's going to be legal. My point is, they clearly wanted the stages to be shown to everybody. That's why they implemented a way for them to be legal, okay, or to be more competitive. So it just seems weird that they would not also do that with Final Smashes. What would be the point of them even making it metered in the first place? What would be the point of scaling them down? It doesn't seem to add up to me. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm looking too deep into this, I don't know. That's why I'm not saying that we should do them now. I'm not advocating for that now. I was advocating for the idea of, you know, of talking about it, but you know, that's in the past now, because clearly we have to go all, if they're not competitive, then we should not do it. But really, we just have to wait and see. But my question to you guys is, if on December 7th, we pop in that disc and we see that there's an ability to turn off rage mode, or maybe the game is way too fast, or characters do way too much damage in this build to the point where people are losing stocks really fast, you know, or you know, it's 2 to 3 stocks, or maybe Final Smashes are balanced and Marf's one hit kill doesn't kill until like 80%, or strong characters have weak Final Smashes, or weak characters have strong Final Smashes. If you believe that there is a way, when we get the final build, that we could balance Final Smashes, would you guys want them to be in the game as an actual default tournament? Or are you completely against the idea, no matter if they are completely balanced, you just want to have 3 or 4 stocks, no rage mode, or rage mode if it's on, we can't help that, you know, blah blah blah, the normal. Would you guys want that? Let me know in the comments if you guys would actually want Final Smashes if they're balanced, or even if they're balanced, you don't want them at all, because I am interested to see what you guys think, or what a good portion of the community thinks. As my final result, like I said, if they are 100% balanced though, I would want them in. If they are 100% balanced, if they are not balanced, if something is just not right, if you can charge the Final Smash by doing nothing, or if you can one-shot somebody, no matter how weak a character is, a character should not be able to one-shot somebody. But that's my take on it, guys. I'd love to hear you guys. I'm gonna have a comedy skit coming up in a few days. If you are new, I had to burp there, Jesus. If you're new, go ahead and subscribe to the crew and become amazing forever.
Boy, that's just crazy.